Today I'm canning tomatoes without the seeds. There's a lot of videos on YouTube showing the easy way to can tomatoes. Leave it to me to show you the hard way to do it. I just don't like tomatoes that have been cooked with their seeds in them because the seeds make the tomatoes bitter. So here's how I can mine. The first thing I do is wash the tomatoes. I take the stem off if there is one, and then I take an apple core and insert it into the tomato about halfway. On the bottom of the tomato, I make an X in the skin with a knife. Then I boil the tomatoes for about 30 seconds until the peels start to crack, then plunge them into cold water. Next, I peel the tomatoes, then cut them in half across their equator. Then I remove the seeds with a spoon and cut the tomato up into chunks. For the top half of the tomato, I punch out the core that I had cut with the apple core, then remove the seeds and chop. Of course, this moves along quicker if it's done assembly line fashion. And yeah, I'm aware that a lot of y'all are thinking I'm crazy about now, but have you noticed that when you buy a can of diced tomatoes in the store, there's no seeds in theirs either? These tomatoes are Better Boys. Then there's Bobby's favorite tomatoes, Big Beef. As you can see, these are some beefy tomatoes. Cutting into them is more like cutting into watermelon, not tomatoes, and they are huge. I always use the hot pack method for canning tomatoes. To do that, add enough water so that they won't stick to the bottom of the pot. Don't cover the tomatoes with water like the books say, or you'll end up fishing around the pot for tomatoes to fill the jars. They'll release juice as they cook, so you're going to end up with more liquid in the end. Boil them gently for 5 minutes, then you're ready to can. Have your jars hot and ready, and lids and rings at a simmer. And heating the lids and rings is optional now. You don't have to do it if you don't want to. So, take a hot jar and fill it within half an inch of the top. For the best quality product and vacuum seal, pack tomatoes one jar at a time. That is a direct quote from the Ball Canning Book. Then add 1 tablespoon of lemon juice and 1/2 teaspoon of salt. The salt is optional. Now, if you were canning quarts, you would need 2 tablespoons of lemon juice and 1 teaspoon of salt. Top off the jar so that the tomatoes are 1/2 inch from the top. Remove any air bubbles with a non-metallic object. Wipe the rim of the jar clean. Add a lid, a ring, and tighten it firmly. Put the jar back into the canner to stay warm until all of the jars are full. When the last jar is full, lower the rack into the canner, making sure there is at least 1 inch of water covering the jars. Put the lid on the canner, and when it begins to boil, that's when you see the steam coming out from under the lid, start the processing time. The processing time is 40 minutes for pints, 45 minutes for quarts. When the time is up, turn off the heat and remove the lid. Let the canner sit for at least 5 minutes, then remove the jars and place them on the counter on a towel to cool. The next day, remove the rings, wash the jars, write tomatoes on the top, and the date that you can them. I use these tomatoes when I'm making spaghetti, chili, cabbage rolls. They're especially good for making salsa. I don't can salsa. It's easy to make it with the canned tomatoes, and the salsa tastes much better than if it was canned. I plan on posting the salsa recipe soon. So that's how I can tomatoes without the seeds. I hope it helps.